In this video, I'm going to show you how to add a real database to your Bolt app using Supabase, and then how to deploy your app on the internet. So let's start by prompting Bolt to build us a simple habit tracking app. So I'm just going to write a simple habit tracking app to start, and then hit generate. And then we're going to let Bolt start generating our app. So I'm going to pause the video while it starts to generate all of these things. All right, so let's see what Bolt built for us on a first try. So we have a home screen. I can put a habit in, go to the gym, a frequency, daily or weekly. I can add the habit. Once I add the habit, I can go down and I can check it off, and that will add a streak. And presumably, if you went back to the app, it would track over multiple days if you were tracking your habit correctly. So now what we're going to do is prompt Bolt to connect this app to Supabase. So I'm going to say, I want to add a real database to this app using Supabase. Please let me know how to do this. So let's just prompt, ask Bolt how to do this, and let's see what response we get here. So first, it's going to start integrating the database schema, adding authentication, and updating the application to use Supabase instead of local storage, which was just on the browser. So I'm going to let it go through this generation, and then I'll unpause the video. Okay, so there are a few things that Bolt is telling us to do. So first, we need to create a new Supabase project in at supabase.com. So I'm going to go over there now. You need to have a Supabase account, which you can do for free. I haven't entered a credit card or anything like that. And I'm going to click New Project under the No Code MBA organization. It looks like I can only have two free projects. So I'm going to go ahead and delete a project that I already have. So one second here. All right. So I deleted one of my projects. I'm going to now generate a new project. The project name, I'm just going to say Bolt Habits App. This is a password. It really can be whatever we want. We're going to delete this later. Generally, you'd want this to be a strong password. And then we'll just click create new project. So it's going to take Bolt about a minute or two to actually create your project. You can see here it says initiating project setup. So I'm going to pause the video and let Bolt finish this initiating the project. Okay, so once your project is initialized, we're going to go back to Bolt. And then what we need to do is go ahead and copy this code that Bolt has created for us. And this is what we're going to do to create our tables. I can just use that copy button in Supabase. Now, I think in the future, Bolt is going to make this even easier and automated. But right now, we need to go back into Supabase and create these tables manually. But it's a pretty easy process. We'll go back into Supabase, and we're just going to go to our SQL editor. We're going to paste in that code, which is basically just creating all of the tables. And then we'll click Run. And now we see we have a success. And now if we go back to the table editor and we refresh, we can see we have database tables now for habit completions and habits. So that was one part of the setup. Another part of the setup is we want to go to authentication, providers, click on email, and then I want to uncheck confirm email. And then we're going to go down and click save. The reason is that if we want to add in email confirmation, there's just a little bit more that we need to do for setup to actually set up an email provider and be able to send those emails. So we're going to allow people to log in without email confirmation. So let's go back to Bolt for a second. So we have the tables created. Now we need to get the project URL and key. We need to update the environment file. So if we go into our code and under the env file, you can see we have the Supabase URL and the key here. So to do this, we're going to go back to Supabase. And if you go to your dashboard under the home button here and scroll down, you can see here we have the project URL and the API key. So I'm going to click the project URL, go back to Bolt, go to our code and paste in the project URL there. And then I'm going to copy the API key here and then go back to Bolt. And now let's go back to the code and paste in the API key here. Okay, and I'm going to just go ahead and click save on the top right. And let's also, we are seeing issues, so let's have Bolt attempt to fix those. So I'm just going to click on that. It's now going to attempt to fix some of the issues that we had here with our integration. So I'm going to let it do that and pause the video. All right, so Bolt says that it's fixed the issues. So let's see if we can actually log in. Interestingly, it's using a magic link, which I do not want to do because I know I don't have email set up. So let me say I'd like to use a real password instead of magic link. I don't think magic links are going to work. So it's going to switch to real passwords now. All right, so here we are. It has this cool modal where you can switch from sign in to sign up. So let's do sign up and let's enter my email and I'll enter a password. Sign up. Check your email to confirm your account. Okay, so it's still interesting. So it must have built in a feature to pop up and tell me to confirm my email, even though we turned that off in Supabase. So I could have it remove that and prompt it. But yeah, here I am logged in. So let's have a habit, which let's say we want to run 1 mile, and we want to do that, let's say daily, and we can add a habit and let's check it off. So what I want to do now is go back to Supabase and see if this is actually being saved in our database. So here we are. Let's go to our database. Actually, sorry, our table editor. Let's click on habits, and I can see this is really cool. This is being saved here. In our actual database, and we have our habits as well. Let's go to users, and yeah, I can see the users as well. And this is the user ID and my email because that's what I use to sign up. So, very cool. It is all working now with a real backend database. Okay, so now that we've done that, what I want to do is actually deploy the app so other people can use it. So let's start by just clicking deploy. And what we're doing is basically telling Bolt to deploy the application. And it's going to start the process here of deploying it to Netlify. And here we go. So it's as simple as just pressing that button. Now it's successfully deployed. And it's creating this temporary URL that you can use to access your application. Or you can transfer this application to your own Netlify account by clicking this URL. But let's go ahead and click on that and go to the actual app. So here we are. This is the URL that it just gave me, and let's sign up. So I'll go ahead and click sign up. Again, it's going to pop up because we didn't tell it to remove that feature, but it's still letting us in. Again, you have to turn that toggle off in Supabase. And now under habit, let's say I want to clean the kitchen, and we want to do that every day. And let's add the habit, and there we go. So now I can check that off. And now let's go back to Supabase and make sure that that worked. So let's go back to our table editor, habits, and here we go. Clean the kitchen daily, and then under habit completions, here we can see basically it's listing every time something is checked off. So that's awesome. It is all working. I hope that you enjoyed this video and you learned how to set up a database with Bolt and Supabase, and how to actually deploy your app onto the internet. These are two really crucial things to know in order to turn your app that you built with Bolt from just a prototype that you can use to something that anyone can use, and you can have persistent data on it as well. Be sure to check the link in our description to go to No Code MBA for a lot more AI and no code education, where you'll learn how to build apps like Airbnb, Reddit, and much more by using no code tools and AI. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel right here to get more content like this for free. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.